It's Lola Raie, and I'm an actress and cheaper by the dozen in Angle, and you are watching FaceTime with Todd Wharton.
Hey guys, so obviously you can see behind me, I'm on a cruise right now. You know, I was just thinking of being on a cruise. Remember the movie Titanic where Jack was just hanging over the board and she wouldn't even pull him up and he ends up just dying in the ice? Like, what the hell? Like, and he didn't even say anything to her. I'm sorry, man, but if that was me and you didn't pull me up, you know I'm going to say something to you. And I wish somebody would have just made a clip of something that pretty much predicted how us men felt if you just left us to drown right in the water. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah.
Iceberg, right ahead.
Iceberg? What do you mean? Turn the boat. We'll be right back with actress Lola Raie. Welcome back to the show, everyone. So my guest tonight is an actress that you can see co-starring right now in the new remake film, Cheaper by the Dozen, starring Gabrielle Union and Zach Braff, that's available right now on Disney+. You're also going to be able to witness her as the lead role in the new animation film that's going to be available in the States October-November time, I'm Bo, the Spirit of the Amazon. But you know what? Let's take a look at a clip.
Deep in the Amazon jungle lies a hidden paradise, home to a young girl.
I'm Imbo of Kandamo, greatest hunter in the whole Amazon.
And when evil invades the Amazon, it's time to unleash her inner hero.
Believe in yourself.
Save Kandamo.
You are the whole Aimbo.
It's me and the jungle now.
Aimbo, Spirit of the Amazon, coming soon.
I'm Zoe.
And this is Paul.
We're the Bakers.
Whose kids are those? They're all ours.
Cheaper by the dozen.
I enjoy being with my kids.
I do too.
I do too.
I do too. You guys are funny.
Has each other's back.
Oh. I can't move.
Thanks for being so average and relatable with average looks and ordinary body.
Uh-huh. Cheaper by the dozen, only on Disney Plus.
Please welcome to the show, Lola Raie. Hey Lola, how you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. Listen, I'm seeing this blue background. It's making me want to just be near the ocean. I want to get out of the city. Are you feeling that way right now? Are you feeling about vacation time?
Yes. I need a vacation. I need the ocean. The ocean is my favorite. I'm like one with the ocean, honestly.
Yeah, I'm one with the ocean when there's no sharks. So,
really? I love sharks.
Yeah, I like them too, just as long as they stay like a mile out. Because I don't think I want to turn around and be like, what's up, bro? Because I'm Italian. They haven't had Italian food, right? And I got oregano on me. So I know they're going to be like, yeah.
Yeah.
I can go for that.
We're different in that way because I had a shark sighting earlier. So, I mean.
Wait. You had a shark sighting or was it an accident or were you in a cage?
Okay. So it was kind of an accident. So I surf. Okay. And so me and my brother went surfing one day, and little did I know what I thought I saw. Like, I thought I saw a fin, and so I got out of the water because I was like, oh, I have a bad feeling about surfing today. And I got out of the water because I thought I saw a fin, and I left my brother in the water, you know, in case he could be fish bait. It's fine. Everything's good. And so I got out of the water, and I didn't want to go back in because I had a bad feeling. And then later that night, little did I know, it was actually the shark. It was an actual shark that I saw. And I just left my brother out there.
Yeah.
Looking like a snack in his wetsuit. So, yeah.
Yeah. Your brother's going to see this interview, right?
Okay. Yeah.
That's good. Right. And he's going to be like, you know what? I think me and Todd are on the same page because Todd's about to get into something. So, you went out of the water, left your brother in there as shark bait, but then you voice a main character of the biggest hunter in the rainforest, which is kind of going the opposite way. See where I'm going with this. So I'm Bo. All right. And we have to go right into that because that's kind of a weird how this is happening right now. You went from brother being a shark bait to being pretty much the queen of the jungle, defending everybody. So let's talk about IMBO right now. It's coming soon. I believe right now it's available in the UK, and it's coming to the States, I believe you said, November. Tell me about this. November, October. So tell me about this role that you're playing, because like I said, you went from bringing your brother to shark bait, but now you're the queen of the jungle. Tell me about this role, because this is really, really cool.
Well, she's just, you know, a young, empowering little lady trying to protect her homeland, and she will do anything she can to protect it from, you know, what are they called? From people that are trying to, like, miners. Yeah, like the miners that are trying to, like, ruin the forest, like ruin her, the Amazon, like ruin her home. And so she has her spirit guides to help her. And she's really just a great role model, if you think about it.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And you know what's crazy? When I did see some of the trailers of, you know what it reminded me of? I don't know if you actually thought about this. You ever see the movie Avatar? Where that's what it kind of reminded me of a little. And it was a different type of role. Because remember, in Avatar, the humans were trying to take over their rainforest for, like, the elements and what the trees offered, where you now are playing a role where you're defending your home from spirits, because in the trailer they show a bulldozer. So I'm like, there's a very similar take here, and I think the kids are going to love this movie, because just watching the trailer, it got me really excited to really see this film. You really did.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. You're welcome. And this is not the first animation, I believe, that you've done. You did something on Galaxy, correct? It was called Creative Galaxy.
Oh, that? Yeah. I was like 6 or something when I did that. Yeah. It was pretty cute. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. But how did you feel taking on, you went from that, then you're becoming a Hollywood actress now. But now you took on a lead role. Like, how crazy is that, that you took on a lead role of an animation feature?
Yeah, that was, like, really crazy. I remember it took, like, maybe, like, a month for the audition process.
Yeah.
It was a lot. Like, I had never done, like, a lead role in anything before. Mm. And so just having that be, like, kind of my first thing, it's pretty cool.
Yeah. It's amazing, and I'm sure you are going to be really excited. And hopefully they do like a red carpet where you get to experience this film in a theater. Because I don't know about you, but I going to the theater and watching films, watching Marvel, watching anything, it's amazing. But to watch a cartoon or an animation or an anime with the stereo surround sound and, you know, and then the graphics, which are crazy today, in a film, how excited are you about that, that hopefully you'll be able to get to see this your first time?
I'm, like, really excited, actually. I haven't seen it, and I really want to see it because it looks so cool, and I've heard other people have seen it, and it's gotten really good reviews. Like, I'm glad it did. I mean, it looks really good. So, yeah, I'm really excited.
Yeah, and you know what the best part about this is? And I talked to a lot of actors about now, not only animation, but films that go from theater to streaming, there's a whole world opening up for you, right? Where even if you can't get to the theater, people can actually adjust their time schedule to actually watch something they really want to watch. And the best part about it is if it does really good on streaming platforms, I definitely see a sequel in this film just by watching the trailer alone. How would you love to be the main title of a sequel, of a series that this may become?
No. Sounds kind of crazy, dog. But I actually didn't think about that.
That's why I'm here.
Oh, yeah. Thank you for your creative mind. Yeah, it actually sounds like it would be pretty cool. I could see it, definitely. Yeah.
Yeah, and there are so many great actors right now that love to take on animation films, because think about a lot of the animation films that have started with one and then turned into series. What happens is bigger actors come into these things and make it even better. I mean, the Lion Kings, and I mean, just think about all these great cartoons that started and they turn into series and sequels and plays. And just imagine if there's a Broadway play based on your animation film, which would be crazy. I mean, this is where a lot of these great shows happen. Great movies happen. and your career can take a path that you never thought would exist. And I mean, you're talented as it is. You have a good look about yourself. You're very bubbly. You have a great personality. So I definitely see something in the works right now. So I'm putting it out there, everybody, that Imbo is going
to be. Thank you for manifesting for me.
Yes, I'm manifesting that for you. I just wish you guys had a red carpet in New York, because we do red carpets. I would love to be there and rock that for you guys. That would be awesome. You're like, yes, yes. Let's do it in New York, New York. Well, you're an LA girl, correct? You grew up in LA?
Yes, I did.
So how was it out there growing up in LA? Did you get the bug right away? Because I know you started at 4, but was this always a dream of yours to be an actress when you were growing up?
I mean, kind of. I've always really been into, like, entertaining people and, like, singing and dancing and, like, acting and stuff. So I did a play when I was 4. Yeah. My mom put me in like this little community play because I was always singing and dancing, and like I would subconsciously memorize things that I see on TV and like perform them for some reason. I don't even remember this happening, and she has videos of it though, so it happened. And so I would do plays, but I couldn't read. Like, I didn't know how to read yet. So this is all happening when I was younger. Don't worry, I know how to read now. But, like, it all happened when I was younger. And so I would have, like, these scripts. And so my mom would have to read the scripts to me, read my lines for me, and right. I would have to memorize them. So I kind of had a knack for it because I have a really good memory and apparently good instincts, I guess, when it comes to acting. And so I did, like, a couple community plays like that. And one of the girls that I had done the play with, her mom was like, oh, your daughter's like really good at this. You should meet with my manager, with her manager. And yeah, that's kind of how it all happened. I met the manager, and then I had agents all within like a month. And then I kind of ended up here.
Yeah, it's crazy how I always talk about lightning and thunder with a lot of people. And lightning crashed for you, really hit hard when you were young. How are you coping with the school right now? Are you doing at-home training, or is this on the road? Like, how do you work that out?
Well, I'm homeschooled. Okay. So I was in public school until like fourth grade. And then like, I kept getting really busy, and I was getting letters because I missed too many days of school to go to work and stuff. Yeah. They're like, you should do Sunday school. You should do summer school. Your child is not in school. And so I was like, oh, okay. Well, oh well. But I've always had good grades. I've always like done really well in school. And so after I started getting letters, my mom was like, okay, we're just going to homeschool you. It's fine. And so from like fifth grade to now, like and ongoing, I have been homeschooled, and it really just, you know, opens up more time and like more freedom to do what I love, you know? Yeah.
And you're really, really good at it. I was impressed. It really was, because, and you know, the funny thing is, we're going to get into the other feature that you're a part of right now that's on Disney Plus, which is, for some reason, Disney. I'm getting everybody from Disney and I'm loving it. But you actually were in a film that I watched during COVID. You were in Yesterday with Jennifer Gardner and Jenna Ortega. And I didn't even realize you were in that. And I'm like, wait, because that was a funny film. I mean, it's about what if parents would give a yes to all their kids. And I'm like, that would be awesome. But then they showed the downfall of it. How did you like working with those two as well? Because those are some pretty iconic actresses.
I love Jennifer Garner. I love Jenna Ortega. Jennifer, it's like really awesome. I love her so much. 13 Going on 30 is like one of my favorite movies.
You know,
so cute. And she works with Mark Ruffalo in it. I love that movie so much. So it was really awesome working with her. And Jenna Ortega, love Jenna Ortega. She's awesome. I love to see what she's doing now. It's great.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So working with them was really cool.
Yeah, you know what's the best part about your career so far? You're learning from a lot of great actors. Not a lot of people can actually say that at a young age. Are you really taking in? And because I've always learned, because I'm a public speaker, that in order to be a teacher, you have to be a student always. And that's how you learn. Are you really appreciating taking in, like, just the people that you're getting to work with and learning from them? And How has your relationships been with a lot of them? Have they been open to you? Like, this is what Hollywood's all about. Do this and do that. How was your relationship with some of these people?
Well, it's pretty good. I mean, I didn't work really close with them, but, you know, right. I still got to talk to them and, like, make a connection with them. Like, Gabrielle Union. Oh my God. Love her. My favorite.
I'm glad she's you said awesome. That.
She was so sweet. She, it's really good to work with, like, different actors because then you get to learn from them. And, you know, being a young actor, you get to, like, see, like, the highs and lows of it. Mm-hmm. And so it's really just a great learning experience.
Of course. And I'm glad we're flowing through this interview. I'm loving it. I'm loving your vibe right now. So if you guys don't know, obviously, I think you guys do, Cheaper by the Dozen with stars Zach Braff and Gabrielle Union. Do you even understand the taking of this film that you're in right now? Because this is a reboot of an iconic film starring one of the biggest comic legends of all time, Steve Martin, right? And then you got Bonnie Hunt, and then my girl Hilary Duff, because I know Haley Duff. I got to interview her recently. When you got to the call that you're going to be on this film, a reboot, were you aware of this film from back? I believe it was like 2003 when this film came out. So you were what? Were you like one?
I wasn't born.
You weren't even born. Okay.
I was like,
are you around?
I was like negative 4 years.
Like, are you around? I wasn't thought of yet. Did you have to watch the film to understand like what you're about to take on?
Oh, I had watched it before, but I like forget movies that I've watched, so obviously I watched it again, and I don't know, it's like really good. I really loved it, and I was like, oh my God, I want to be a part of a reboot of this. So it was like kind of cool, kind of crazy, you know.
Yeah, and it's a really great film. I love the concept of it. You take two families from the opposite sides of the tracks, and you bring them together. And I'll be honest with you, what I loved about the reboot was, and I'm seeing this in a lot of films, they're bringing together different cultures in marriages. And I think a lot of films are doing that now because they're showing that diversity can always get along, because at the end of the day, we're human. And I think you're a part of a film that brings together that camaraderie of what human being is all about. It's about just getting along. It's about having fun. How did you feel about seeing the roles and the characters that were coming into this film?
Ooh, well, I mean, it's a good question.
Thanks.
It's pretty crazy. I mean, everyone did really good at their role, so that was good. I feel like they all fit the role, and I feel like everyone kind of like, from how different they all were, they all worked together so well, and it like meshed perfectly.
Right.
No,
I love it. And you play Talia, correct? You play the young girl, Talia. Is there anything about this character that you can relate to, or was it a hard push just to get into that character?
I mean,
has Talia gone, you know, shark diving and just threw her brother in there and just left him? Something like that.
I mean, like, I hope not. This can't be a method acting thing. Sorry, guys. I can't do that. But, I mean, Talia was, like, kind of easy, kind of not. I mean, yeah. I always, like, not every single role, but I bring a little bit of myself to every role, like, my personality. But, you know, you switch it up a little bit. You just add something different every time and, like, really try to build the character. I don't really remember doing anything different, like, anything, like, drastic. Yeah. But, yeah.
Very cool. So you have these two coming out. I mean, well, not coming out. Right now, Cheaper by the Dozen is available on Disney Plus. Great platform, by the way, because I've been talking to a lot of Disney actors, and you're in that family now. Disney Plus is Marvel and Star Wars, right? And now your film that you're in is literally, on my opinion, the biggest streaming platform on the planet. I mean, because I go in and I watch Marvel all the time, but now that I know that your film is there, I'm definitely going to finish, you know, watching it, because I love seeing films, especially if people I interview and be like, wow, she was better than I thought. And it's an honor for me to keep meeting people from Disney, because Disney has just got a, Disney has a knack for really just casting great actors. And seriously, I think you're one of them. I think you have a huge career ahead of you. And I would love to see Einbow in theater coming out hopefully in October, November. And I definitely see a series for you as well. So we're going to keep our fingers crossed for that. I think it's going to be great. And is there anything in the works right now that you could talk about that you didn't sign an NDA for that at least you can get into? Because we all know how the Hollywood world is.
There's nothing you can know. My lips are sealed. Everything in this brain stays in my brain. Nothing.
Oh, man, I was trying to
follow my Instagram. You could follow me for updates on what I am doing. It's Lola Raie Official, so you should definitely go check that out.
Exactly. Yeah, and I follow her too, guys, so definitely check her out, Lola Raie Official. Definitely check her out on Disney Plus, Cheap About a Dozen, and then coming soon to a theater near you, we'll get at Vinebow, the animation film, and it's going to be here October, November in the States. Lola, you are such a pleasure to have on FaceTime with Todd Wharton, and thank you for stopping by. I appreciate you.
Thank you.
So, Lola, thank you for being a guest on FaceTime with Todd Wharton, and thank you for taking the time out from your busy schedule and joining me right here in Times Square to talk about your new films coming out. Congratulations on Cheaper by the Dozen, and of course, Einbow, the spirit of the Amazon. And hey, like I said, I'm telling you right now, based on that trailer and your personality alone, I can definitely see a sequel to this movie. I think it's great, and I can't wait to see it in the theaters here in October, November. And guys, like she said, definitely go check her out on Instagram, Lola Raie Official. And you know what? I hope everybody enjoyed this interview, because I know I did. But like I always say, guys, until the next time, if you're not living a passionate life, then whose life are you living? Take care, guys. I'll see you soon.
He is the most interesting man in the world.
I'm not always on YouTube. When I am, I make sure I'm subscribed to FaceTime with Todd Wharton. Be thirsty, my friends.